the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, one true God forever and ever. Amen. Dearly beloved in Christ, have you ever experienced that heartbreaking moment when all our dreams fall apart like a pack of cards? When all our dreams turn into nightmares? We all have. Have you ever asked in pain, "Why me?" when all those dreams were shattered? We all have. But today, let us meditate on the life and character of Joseph, who, when confronted with a series of problems in life, never asked God, "Why me?" Instead, I believe he was bold enough to say in his heart, "Try me." We know that patience is a virtue. In this Sunday's Gospel portion, Saint Matthew chapter 1 verses 18 to 25 tells us that how a righteous man's patience helped a family's survival, and through that God's plan is implemented. Saint Joseph is that man who patiently listens to the words of God and protected the family from separation. First, let us take a stock of the situation that Joseph was in. It was time of excitement. Mary and Joseph were betrothed to one another. As per the tradition, they were almost married. So Joseph would have been very excited about the future he would have with Mary. It was a time of expectation. Any couple before their marriage would have great expectations about their future lives. Surely, both Joseph and Mary were counting down the days until they could be together and live together as a husband and wife. It was a time of embarrassment. It was during this time that Joseph discovered about Mary's pregnancy. This would have been a source of great embarrassment both to Mary and Joseph, as well as to their respective families. It seemed that all the dreams Joseph had for the future had been shattered by this devastating news. Yet Joseph waited patiently. He meditated on the future course of action. He did not meditate intellectually nor by reasoning. Rather, he meditated in faith. He was in deliberation with God. How many of us actually talk to God or discuss our plans with Him before executing it? Of course, making plans is normal and acceptable. We must make plans in life if we would like to succeed. It is said that if you don't know where you are going, you will never get there. We must make plans for retirement, saving money for homes and cars and college tuition. We seek the proper college to attend, and we plan on finding a career that is fulfilling. Plans are a vital part of life. But the question is God involved in those plans? This is where Joseph stands out from the rest of us. There are three important traits that I found in him the most inspiring. First, his unconditional obedience. Many men would have walked away from the Lord and from Mary at that moment, but not Joseph. As soon as he awoke from his dream, he rose and carried out the commandment of the Lord. At this moment in Joseph's life, he was not interested in what the community thought about him. He simply wanted to carry out the will of the Lord for his life. In spite of his question, his fears and his concerns, Joseph sets out by faith to obey the Lord. Secondly, his unwavering commitment. When Jesus was an infant, Saint Joseph had to take his family and uproot them to Egypt to flee Herod's murderous threat. In Egypt, he would have had to find new work a new shelter for his family and stay indefinitely in a foreign land. But Joseph was patient. Joseph trusted in God's providential care for him. Patience and trust in God does not mean that we will not face daily anxieties. But this patience and trust in Lord helped Joseph to unwavering commitment to God. This patience will not just help us to be committed to God, but also to our spouses, parents, friends, and society. Thirdly, his unfailing completion. Joseph did not abandon Mary and Jesus at any point in time. He was instrumental in God's economy of salvation. Joseph's trust in God's providential care helped him to complete God's plan without any compromise. It is by God's grace that we can deal with the daily frustrations, the faults of others, the little inconveniences, and the big problems that face us. In trials, we learn how to grow in virtue and live in God's grace. Exercising patience and mercy, especially when dealing with others or with things out of our control, always bring about good and also helps us. It also leads us to fulfill God's plans for us. It is these things that helped Joseph completed the task that was entrusted to him. As I said in the beginning, what do we do when our dreams are shattered? When your dreams turn into nightmares, what are you doing about it? Some people fix it themselves. Some people quit. Some people abandon God. Joseph never did any of these. His patience and trust in God led him to obedience and commitment. When his dreams were shattered, he submitted to the will of God, and then it was transformed into a source of glory and rejoicing. May God help us to overcome the hurdles of life, and may God help us to develop a character and attitude like that of Joseph. May God bless us.